reason, let me give you one. He gave you a brand new mercy with the rising of the sun. Say, hey, hey. Are you ready? Hey. For the chains that come from the enemy, I utterly destroyed you when the praise rings. Are you? Hey, hey. Are you ready?
Pastor Al, what is going on? War Room, what is up? What is up? What is up? Good evening tonight. Pastor, how are you doing this evening?
We're going to surprise my mom with a gift.
That was taking it back a little bit, right? A little Fred Hammond for everybody.
Fred Hammond, listen, if you don't know Fred Hammond, unfriend me on all social platforms immediately.
Oh, my gosh. Oh, my gosh. I mean, we went way back, but I was even when we were doing the before the broadcast, like, Pastor, what song is that? You're like, Fred Hammond. Like, oh my gosh, I totally forgot about Fred Hammond.
There, man. You know what, Tim? I'm outside today. I'm in my courtyard.
It's
beautiful out here right now. Yeah. And the weather's changing. And man, we curse COVID-19 in Jesus' name right now.
Yeah. Beautiful weather. San Diego can't get away from it. It's like 80 degrees out here. Beautiful. It looks great right there in your backyard, right at home with Pastor.
You too. You look great too, man. Is that your studio?
I'm in the blueprint room. So I'm just downloading.
Hey, that's the war room / kingdom shifters.
Yeah. The little studio room.
Dude, what's happening on kingdom shifters, man? I'm going to be on.
I'm super excited. I announced it this morning. I had a Pastor Mark from Scotland. We announced that you're going to be on with us Friday. And I've been pumping you up all weekend. Cause I know that you've got the evangelist gift in you. And, I believe you're gonna speak to some dry bones Friday night. Come on, somebody. Come on, man.
Yeah, you know I'm really feeling like things are waking up. The water is stirring. The raging flood is rising. There are those who ride the wave, and there are those who raise the tide. And I believe that it's the intercessors. It's the prayer warriors.
Yes.
It's the people who are fasting. It's the people who are interceding.
Yeah.
They're raising the tide for this new wave that God is bringing in the earth, this wave of revival. Some people have been praying for decades for a move of God like this, Tim.
My God, yeah.
There are people that have been praying. They spent their entire life. They said, I don't want to die until I see a revival take place in the earth, a revival take place in the in America. And I believe that we are on the threshold of a powerful, unprecedented move of God with super abundant blessings of souls.
Yes.
Into the house of God. So I'm excited to be on the Shifters, man. But welcome to the War Room tonight. Yes. Everybody who's tuning in, wherever you're tuning in from, if you can let us know on the comments. We've had people tuning in from Holland, people tuning in from England, people tuning in from South Africa, people tuning in from different states all over the country.
Right.
Also mostly have our Victory Outreach San Diego family tuning in. And Tim, that's why we started the War Room, isn't it?
Yeah, this is really this is spiritual strategy. And, you know, when we got together, Pastor, in your office, we were talking about how we can really be able to impart spiritual strategy from heaven. You know, the disciplines, right? Prayer, fasting, worship. I mean, the essentials that we need as believers in our church to really, like you said, raise the tide in this season. And this is really God given. I mean, as far as the framework, how it's been put together, and now how even every week, just the strategy of heaven being released. I mean, if you want to find out what's going on at VOSD, you got to come to the War Room and hang out with our pastor.
And it's been so strategic, Tim, because little did we know that we were already having this program on Monday nights at 7 p.m., the War Room. Right. And then all of a sudden, boom. I mean, we were already moving, and then, but it's amazing to see how the Holy Spirit was already preparing us, wasn't he?
Yeah, and that's the great thing is that as he was showing us the strategy of War Room, we are seeing just people being blessed, directed. But really, Pastor, the whole premise is spiritual strategy.
Right.
And I know a few weeks ago you shared on the mulberry tree, which was very prophetic. And I think for VOSD, this is Monday nights. This is where we have to be, right?
Yeah.
Especially now in a time of separation. And I love what you talked about yesterday. And we're going to get into that here in a few minutes. But I really believe Monday nights, this is the place to be in order to increase our frequencies to heaven. So I'm excited for the War Room tonight because we have your good friend, our good friend, Pastor Matthew.
Man, I'm excited. My brother is on the show tonight, Pastor Matthew K. Thompson, Jubilee Boston. So we'll be hearing from him in a moment. But we had a good weekend, didn't we?
Yeah. Pastor, before we talk about Sunday, I do want to talk to everybody watching in. And I know that you I wanted to run this by you, but if you're out there, can you do me a favor? Can you share the link? Can you tag about 10 people? And this is what we're going to do tonight. I actually got the okay from headquarters. Come on, somebody. But this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to give away 3 books tonight signed from Pastor Al. So if you're out there tonight and you're watching right now, I'm going to look. And while I look, I'm going to look for someone to tag 10 people. So you're going to tag 10 people. And while you're doing that, I'm going to ask Pastor Al what his favorite chapter is in his new book, Rise Up Now. Pastor, talk to us about your favorite chapter in this book, because this is a great read for people to get to know you, for people to know you and Georgina, but most importantly, to understand the call of God upon your life and how you really wrote about it. Give us your favorite chapter.
All right. I'm going to give you my favorite chapter. And I was really thinking about it. And honestly, my favorite chapter is chapter 1.
Okay.
Now, chapter 1 is my favorite chapter because that is the chapter that talks about how I got saved. But that chapter also talks about how I met my beautiful wife, Georgina.
Ooh, come on now.
And it tells everybody where the love story began.
Yeah, and that's a beautiful story. you got to read it, right? I think this is a good segment to say, hey, this is a time to read it. But Pastor, you know, really the whole purpose of the book was to get to know you and Georgina. For those that are new to our church and for those new that are part of Victory Arch San Diego, this was specially designed for them, right, Pastor?
Yes, it was. And there's so many, we literally have over 1,800 to 2,000 first-time guests in our church every single year. And, you know, we have done everything we can to connect with them. But I just felt in my heart that it was time to begin to really put something in their hands. I got to know Georgina and I, that got to understand what Georgina and I's philosophy of spiritual development was, that when they come to Victory Arch San Diego, that they would not only catch the vision, but they would also catch the heartbeat for discipleship. And that's something that Georgina and I have been involved in now for over 25 years. From the very beginning of our ministry, we started the Urban Training Center in Bridgeport, Connecticut in 1997. We've gone on to do some other things, but discipleship has always been at our heart. So we are a disciple making church. That's why our church is doing so well right now. And I want to congratulate our people.
Yeah.
Our church is growing. In these last month and a half, we've grown by 197 families.
Wow.
Our finances have exponentially grown. People are being healed and saved. I received literally three testimonies yesterday of people who received manifested physical miracles in their body.
Wow.
So Rise Up Now is a book about developing your spiritual potential. I talk about that process. And I believe it's a book that any new believer needs, anybody who's in the home needs. And if you have people that you've been witnessing to, give them this book. It will give them hope to not just get saved, but to become a disciple of Jesus Christ.
Yeah, well, I see everybody starting to tag everybody, Pastor. So I want to give away three books. And will you sign those books for us?
Look, man. I mean, I don't like promoting the book. And that was the reason you needed to get approval. But, you know, if we're going to give them away for free, I'll promote it. And we'll do five tonight.
Okay.
We'll five. But they gotta share this right now. They gotta share the show because my friend Matthew Thompson's about to come on and the Holy Ghost is about to hit this place, bro. So I'll give away five books to people who are gonna start a watch party right now. So come on.
Start a watch party, tag up to, there's already like two people tagged to the 10 people already. So I'm gonna get you right after, but do me a favor, hit the hearts and tag and share.
Yeah.
And you know, Pastor's he's very generous. If you know him and you know him well, he is a giver. And so he just raised it up two more. I said, I got the okay.
I tried to give 50 books the other day. And my daughter's like, Dad, what are you doing? So I said, okay, well, I'll listen to you.
Oh, my goodness. So five books we're giving away. Tag somebody, share it. I'm going to find out who it is, Pastor. And at the end, I'm going to announce him. And I know you're going to personally sign it. But I'm excited. I know Pastor Matthew is ready to go. But yesterday.
Let's go, man. Let's get Matthew on.
You want to get him on? All right.
Yeah, man. It's 10 p.m. Eastern time.
All right. Here we go. So you want to roll him in?
Let me introduce him.
There you go.
Let me introduce our guest for tonight. He's a good friend of Georgina and I. He's a powerful man of God. He's the pastor of one of the largest churches in Boston in New England. It's called Jubilee Boston. When Georgina and I were living in Boston for 5 months, we found this church and made it our church home. And we experienced the touch of God in such a powerful way. Our lives were never the same. It comforted us in literally the hardest season of our life. And God used not only Pastor Matthew, but his family to minister to us in that time of need. Whenever we had family from Victor IH come to town, we took them straight to Jubilee. And they were also ministered to. And he has become a great friend. We consider him family at Victor Outreach San Diego, and he's a brother to me. So I want to welcome my brother from another mother, Pastor Matthew K. Thompson.
And God used not only Pastor Matthew, Woo! But his family to minister to us in Matthew. That time of need. Whenever we had family for Victor
Outreach, you hear me?
Town, we took him straight to Jubilee.
Okay, it's a little delay.
Also ministered to, and he has become a great friend. We consider him family at Victor Outreach San Diego, and he's a brother to me. So I want to welcome my brother from another mother, Pastor Matthew K. Thompson.
Yo! Matthew, what's going on? Can you hear me?
You know, I can't see you on my device.
Okay, but can you hear my voice? Because I can hear you great.
And I can't hear you.
Oh, you can't hear me. Okay. Tim, why don't you fix it?
What I'm going to do is I'm going to
go out and come back in. Because we can see and we can hear you.
Yo! Can you see?
Can you hear my voice? Because I can hear you great.
Pastor Matthew, you may have to come back in.
Oh, you can't hear me. Okay.
Well,
you have to come back in, Pastor.
Okay. I'll.
Okay.
All right. That's okay.
He's gonna come back. He's gonna come back in.
Everybody, stay with us. He'll be back.
Yeah, stay with us.
Look, Tim. This is the new normal. Welcome to the new normal, dude.
Yeah, I'm telling you. This is we're live, so this is part of being live, right,
bro? This is the new normal, dude. I mean, how many pastors are watching right now? They go on Zoom with their churches, with all their people, and someone has a mic on.
Here I am.
Oh, there you go.
Hallelujah.
All right, man.
Here we go. We didn't lose nobody. We didn't lose nobody. We gained people.
Hey, Matt.
Come on, somebody. Welcome,
welcome to the war room and welcome to the new normal.
Listen, man. Look, brother. I got my sweatshirt on. I'm ready for battle. You know, this is war.
Woo. Bro,
man, thank you so much, man, for the invite. As you know, man, we are family, man. We are brothers, man. It's like God somehow uniquely like put us together for not just such a time of the season that you were going through, that you and Georgina were going through in your family, but for such a time as this.
Yeah.
It's like the Lord has uniquely kind of fashioned our ministries and our lives together, man. It's a great honor. As you know, man, you know, when you travel and you get an opportunity to preach somewhere that is not, it's not like a, you don't feel like a guest. It's like, when I came to your church, man, it was like, I'm home.
Come on, brother. Hey, you even offered to be the pastor for a little while. So thank you, brother.
Yo, we pastor twin churches, man. Our churches are Jubilee and Victory Outreach San Diego, man. We are twin churches, man. I honor you. I honor Georgina. I honor the incredible work that you guys are doing there in San Diego, man. And bro, when you texted me a couple of days ago saying that you wanted to be on the war room, I was like, yo!
Come on, man. You know better than that, dude.
This is what I'm talking about, man. Because you already know I am a prayer warrior, man. I pray until, you know, one thing I said when I was in San Diego, as I encouraged everyone that was there and everyone that was watching on YouTube and live stream all over the place, I said, you got to pray until you see what you heard.
Ooh, that's good.
Can I get an amen, somebody?
Come on, brother. That's what I'm talking about.
You got to keep praying until you see what you heard. Don't stop praying. Don't stop believing. Don't stop standing. If there was ever a time, Al, if there's ever a time in the history of the world where the prayer warriors and the intercessors and the atmosphere shifters and those that are rising up, if there's ever a time for that to happen, it is right now. We've been saying it for years in our churches, right?
Right, absolutely.
We've been praying that the knowledge of the glory of the Lord would cover the earth like the waters cover the sea. Right. I know in our church that we were at a conference. You were at a conference with us in Boston where I had us turn to the north, the south, the east, and the west, right?
That's right.
And now look what's happening. It's like the message of the gospel of Jesus Christ is literally going around the world. To God be the glory.
Absolutely, man. And the nets are breaking.
Oh!
You know, when Jesus was ministering to the multitudes, man, and he jumped into Peter's boat, right?
Yeah.
And then Peter said, you know, we've been toiling all night. You know, he told him, launch out to the deep. He said, we've been toiling all night. We've caught nothing. I know there's a lot of pastors, a lot of leaders out there, a lot of Christians that feel like they were toiling. They were laboring in vain. But wow. Now, then the Lord says, cast your net, right? He cast out his net. He says, is that your word? I will do it. And there were so many fish in the net.
Right.
And I love what you said, Pastor Matt. You said, we got to pray until we see what we heard.
Yeah.
And what I heard is this, is I heard revival is coming in the form of the super abundant blessing of souls.
Wow.
Souls.
Praise. Wow. Praise. Listen, every morning, right? Every morning we have morning prayer, right?
Right.
But we have morning prayer also now that, you know, this COVID thing has happened. We have morning prayer online every single morning from 6 to 7:30. And I'm there online calling on the name of the Lord. I actually see a couple of times I've seen Georgina. I've seen Aldo. I've seen some of my family on there. Well, just this morning, I spoke from Galatians in the pastor's scripture where it says, don't grow weary in doing well.
Come on.
For in due season, you will reap a harvest as long as you don't give up, as long as you don't faint. Therefore, look what it says. Then in verse number 10, everyone talks about the verse 9 passage because that's like the famous passage, you know, don't grow weary in doing well for in due season. But in verse number 10, it says, therefore, as we have the opportunity, let us do good for all people, especially to those who belong to the family of believers, which means that we have a responsibility to pray and to do good because the harvest. And so when it's talking about don't grow weary in doing well, it's talking about prayer. It's talking about the kingdom. It's talking about, man, don't stop praying until you see what you heard.
Now, absolutely.
I have an incredible testimony. I know you have an incredible testimony of never stop praying, never stop believing. Even though there have been times in my life where it seemed like the more I prayed, the more the enemy tried to attack my faith.
There you go.
I'm not going to allow what the enemy does to try to interfere with my faith, because my faith is so much stronger than my fear. Come on, somebody.
Man, you know what, Matt? It's funny that you say that, because I really believe that we're coming into a moment, not a season, but we're coming into a very window, a little moment where the enemy is becoming ferocious against people. Wow. Because like you said, in that scripture, the Bible says, do not grow weary in well-doing, but in due season, right?
Due season, you know,
God will close one door to open another, but it's hell in the hallway.
Yay!
And so we're standing in the hallway, and here comes the enemy with the spirit of heaviness, with the spirit of anxiety, with the spirit of fear. You know, right now we had a report in our city, Matt, where they say, you know, all the general crimes are down, but domestic abuse is up. Child abuse is up. Frustration in marriage is up. And what I really believe that this is a season in prayer right now where we, as the people of God, we need to begin to bind the strong man.
Yeah.
We need to begin to use our authority in prayer. What do you think about that?
Well, bro, I mean, as soon as you say authority in prayer, like my mind just goes boom, right? But before I go there, you know, you said something. You said you want to bind the spirit of anxiety and bind the spirit of fear.
Right.
Here's one of the spirits I think that the people of God, the children of God, the prayer warriors need to bind. Bind the spirit of fainting.
Ooh, I like it.
That we will not faint. That we will not lose, that we will not throw in the towels. Because here's the thing, for many of you that are watching online right now, and you're watching this war room with this powerful man of God and, you know, his friend that just happens to pray a couple of hours a day. Right? Because hear me, if the enemy can't get you to go backwards, right?
Right.
If the enemy can't get you to go back to your life of crime or drugs or confusion or depression, if the enemy can't get you to go back, then he'll try to get you to stay still. He'll try to get you to tread water. He'll try to get you to be at a place where you become complacent.
And right.
So I believe that what has happened in this pandemic is that the enemy, I hear the Lord speaking to me so many times, wake up, wake up, wake up. Don't faint. Don't give up. It's not the time to get tired. It's time to get energized. Actually, it's a season of rest. It's a season of jubilee. It's a season of preparation. Because hear me, the nets are going to break, right? But hopefully we can mend the nets in this season that we can even have a greater harvest in the future. And in that passage of scripture, what happened? Peter had to ask for partners. Another thing that's happened, Al, is that men of God, ministries of God, we're partnering together.
Yes.
We could do more together than we could ever do apart. There's a greater authority that we have, Al.
Yes.
When you call me and say, Pastor, look, man, I need you to pray for my daughter. I need you to pray for my church. I need you to pray for my city. One can chase 1,000, right?
Absolutely.
Two can put 10,000 to flight. When we unite together in prayer, that's why whenever you come to Boston, and I come to San Diego, something supernatural happens.
That's right. Absolutely.
Because of the authority
and the
incredible encounter that we have based upon if two can touch and agree, asking anything on the earth, it will be done.
That is exactly the word, where two or three. And then the Bible also says where two or three gather.
Gather. Woo!
And he is what? He's there in the midst.
Yeah.
Matthew, yeah. I'm holding up your book, Atmosphere Shift.
Yo.
You are the atmosphere shifter yourself.
Well, this listen. I am an atmosphere shifter, but I just want to prophesy to everyone out there, you are an atmosphere shifter.
Yes.
And I want you to type there on Facebook, wherever you are, I am an atmosphere shifter. Atmosphere shift now.
Well, Matthew, look, let me look at this book, man, because I've read this book like four times. And I believe it's like here. And I haven't preached out of it yet, so... If when I do, I'll send you some royalties. But look, chapter 2, atmosphere. And in this chapter, you talk about different rooms in the house. Right now, that's all we're doing.
Yo.
We wake up in the morning in our bedroom to the kitchen, to go to the living room. We spend the whole day in the living room. Right. And then we go back to bed tired from spending the whole day in the living room.
Yeah.
I love what you talked about in the book, that every room carries a spirit.
Yeah. Well, here's the thing that's so incredible. So on Easter, right? And right. I know you had the same experience. You're preaching to an empty room, right?
Right.
But you're preaching to thousands of people, right? And the theme for that the Lord gave to me for Easter was total praise.
Ooh.
Okay? So, and we had a virtual choir. We had a whole thing. And I spoke from Psalm 150.
Right.
You know, praise the Lord. Praise God in his sanctuary. And at that particular moment, I said to the congregation, look, your home is now your sanctuary.
Woo!
Your living room is now your sanctuary. Your bedroom is now your sanctuary. Your car is your sanctuary. You know, let everything that hath breath praise the Lord. Where can we praise him? In the sanctuary. And now what has happened, Al, is that scripture has come alive, that the knowledge of the glory of the Lord will cover the earth like the waters cover the sea. Because now the church is now meeting in the sanctuary. Now, in the historical times, right, a city was anything with four walls.
Right.
A church has four walls.
Okay.
That's why it is said that we should be a city set upon a hill that cannot be hid.
Right.
Well, your house has four walls, which means that not only is your house a house, but your house is a church and your house is a city. Which means that I'm prophesying for those people that are watching that you are the shepherd of your neighborhood.
Ooh.
You are the pastor of your street, and that there needs to come a revival that happens in Victory Word Outreach, that happens in Jubilee. But how about it happens right there on your street, that you can actually shift the atmosphere of your neighborhood. You can actually shift the atmosphere of that area. Now, when I had that revelation of the book about every room has an atmosphere, you know, that was when my designated space of prayer was my sanctuary in one of my campuses. But now, Al, I've learned that I've taken a war room, a room in my house. It used to be my man cave, and now I've got scriptures all on that wall. I turn the TV off. I get in there and I call on the name of the Lord.
Right.
Because when you pray, mountains move. Heaven attends to our voice and to our prayer. And so I recognize that I have a hard time praying in my kitchen. because I want to eat food, right? You know what I'm saying? I can't pray in my bedroom because my wife is too beautiful. You know what I'm saying?
Hello.
It's like, you know, because my bedroom has an atmosphere. You know, the kitchen has an atmosphere. Sometimes your living room has an atmosphere, but you have to, and I say it in the book, you have to set a time, you have to set a place, and you have to sanctify a space where you can hear God, where you can do warfare in the heavens. And a part of the war room, the beautiful thing about the war room, Al, and I know you guys have this prophetic revelation, is that it's not just that you're fighting in the war room, but you are preparing.
Yes.
You are planning.
Yes.
That you are strategizing.
Yeah.
That you are taking dominion, that you are taking authority. And I'm prophesying to you, Al, and everyone that is watching, that in Joshua, when the Lord says that every place where your feet tread belong to you, yes, territory is yours, and land is yours, and business opportunities are yours. And those entrepreneurs that are watching, there is great increase, and there's a double portion of God's grace that's going to be released upon you. But how about this? The land that God wants you to take now is the internet.
Woo!
Every place where your face is, every place where your voice, whether it's Be Live, whether it's Zoom, whether it's Facebook, whether it's YouTube, you will occupy that space
because
you are an atmosphere shifter.
Oh, my God. My God. This is powerful. I hope everybody that's listening, your heart is being ignited. I know that my heart is ignited, just like every time I talk to my good friend, Pastor Matthew, because this is a man who has dedicated his whole life to prayer. And I want to thank you, Pastor Matthew, because, you know, ever since me and you have come into relationship, you know, being a part of the Ministry of Victory Outreach, God has given us a very clear vision. And that's to reach the inner cities of the world, to raise up an army out of the inner cities, you know, people coming off drug addiction, coming out of gang violence, coming out of prison, coming out of despair and hurt all over the world. That's a mission and a vision God's given us, but that's not an easy task.
Right.
And I know that there are people listening tonight.
Yeah.
And you said something in your last talk just a minute ago about taking territory.
Yeah.
And when I took over San Diego, my wife and I, we came in with that mentality that we were not going to be a church under the radar. We weren't going to be God's best kept secret. But we were going to take territory for his glory, territory for the ministry. And I could tell you this, Pastor Matt, for a few years, we did okay with our ideas. We did okay with some of our plans. You know, how many, no man's plans are man's plans, but the Lord has plans.
Yeah.
Something happened, Pastor Matthew, in the spirit realm when my wife and I begin to start to break through. And I'm going to use this word because it's my show, but I think we pissed the devil off.
Yo, you got it. You better believe
and what happened was, what had happened was, there was a fierce attack on our faith,
yeah.
A fierce attack on our life. You know, whenever you're trying to take territory for God, the enemy's not going to roll out the red carpet and let you come in. And when I came into relationship with you, I want to thank you because, you know, I have people in my life, you being one of them, that challenge areas of my life. Pastor Sonny, my spiritual father, our founder, our apostle, he challenges my life in every area. He's an apostle.
Yeah.
I have other friends, Pastor Sonny Jr. He challenges my area of life in vision and character. I've got other people that challenge my life. But the area where God has used you to challenge my life is in the area of not only praying, but it's in the area of fasting and taking spiritual territory.
Yeah.
Matthew, let me ask you this question, because this is an important question for our viewers. How important is it to fast?
well,
come on, bro.
So you already know there's a story in the Bible where the disciples, they're trying to cast out this demon, right? And the demons is kind of like, nah, we ain't rocking with you. We don't really know you like that, right? And so they go to Jesus and they're like, Jesus, you know what I'm saying? We're having a problem with this boy and his father and his son and the problem. So the Jesus goes over, casts the demon out. The demon goes. The next day, you know, the disciples being kind of good disciples, but kind of feeling kind of down. They're kind of walking by with Jesus. They're like, yo, Jesus, like, what happened? Like, why couldn't we do that? You know? And the Lord said very clear to them that there are certain things that you will not be able to accomplish without fasting and prayer. Now, here's the thing. You can pray without fasting, but you cannot fast without praying, which means that there are certain territories that you cannot take by just praying, which means that you have to add another dimension of fasting. Woo. But here's the thing, Al, when you take territory, and you said it, recognize that the enemy has occupied that space for a period of time.
Right.
And the enemy's not just going to let that thing go. No, that's why you have to go and take it. And I'm prophesying to whoever is watching that you are walking into a season that everything that the enemy stole from you must be returned back to you with interest, but you have to go and you have to take it. And when you face the enemy, when you come into contact with the enemy, it's not time to throw in the towel.
No.
It's not time to run. It's actually the time to rejoice. It's actually the time to pray harder. It's actually the time to link arms with your prayer warriors,
right,
and those generals, because you're saying, hey, you know what? The enemy does not want me to go forward. The enemy wants me to retreat. But
right,
the fact that I see the enemy means that I must move forward. Here's the question that you must ask yourself in this time of taking territory. Abraham Lincoln asked this question. He said, are the times fit for you? Are you fit for the times, or are the times fit for you?
Come on.
So have you been prepared to take this territory? Or is this territory, is this giant, is this adversity, is this pandemic, has it been created for you?
Good Lord.
Has it been set up? Now, I'm not saying the Lord sent this pandemic, but
no,
he allowed it. So
right,
therefore, this situation
right
is preparing something. It is causing you to grow in another capacity, in another dimension. And so territory has to be taken. It's
right
not going to be given.
Woo.
No one is just going to allow you. And I told you this story when I was at your church. You know what I'm saying? You got a lion in your house. You got a lion that's taken over your space. You know what I'm saying? You can't walk in there saying, please, Mr. Lion, can you please come out and give
Woo
me my room back? The lion's going to be like, are you crazy? You need to make sure that you have authority, that you know who you are, that you know whose you are. And you need fasting and you need prayer.
My God.
Listen, you can change. Think about this. You can change without transformation.
Come on.
You cannot experience transformation without change.
Woo.
You can change without transformation, but true transformation, true atmosphere shifting, true territory taking, true transformation can only happen in the midst of change.
Right.
So the question is this. In the last 6 weeks, the last 8 weeks, the last 2 months that we've been in this pandemic, what are some things that you knew needed to change, but
Ooh
now this quarantine has forced you to change, and now you're saying, Lord, I'm so grateful that you have allowed me to change, but I just don't want to stay stuck in that place of change. Lord, I want to be transformed.
My God. Let me just breathe.
Because, Al.
Hey, everybody needs to take a deep breath right now.
Because, Al, we're not just going to go through this.
Right.
We're going to grow through this.
Right.
Well, your church is going to quadruple in size.
Praise God.
Your church is going to quadruple an impact and increase around
yeah
the world.
Right.
And think about that. Victory Road Outreach already has over 600 plus churches. I mean,
right,
your church already has thousands of people.
Right.
But through this season, through the intentionality of waiting on God and hearing God's instruction,
right,
you're not just surviving, you're
right
thriving.
Yes. You know, Matt, I want to say something in long lines of what you're talking about. And I love what you talked about. You can have change without transformation. We sing a song in our church. You might be familiar with it. It's a pretty good song. It's okay. It's an okay song. It's called "You Have Rescued My Life," and I'm never going back.
Never.
That song's all right. Back. It's all right. That song's all right.
That's my response.
My response is, but brother, that's our song because we're never going back. And what I really believe is this: is once you've been stretched to a capacity, you can't shrink back to your old capacity. Yeah. And I believe that God is using this season to grow people to places that they're never going to go back to their old way of doing things. This is not going to be a season of prayer. It's going to be a lifestyle of prayer. It's not going to be a season of fasting. It's going to be a lifestyle of fasting. Because what's going to happen, Matthew, is they're going to get so addicted to taking territory.
Whoa!
See, that's what I see in my pastor. He's in Panama. He's in South Africa. He's in Europe now. He's in San Jose. He gets addicted to taking territory because David, King David, said the Lord broke him through like water.
Yeah.
And Jacob, when he wrestled with God, he said, I will not let you go till you bless me. But you know this, that once God blesses you, you never want to let him go.
Hey, and I sense so, it. I feel it.
The spirit of breakthrough is in this place. But I also believe this about fasting, Pastor Matthew. Tell me what you think about this. But I really believe that when the people of God really set their heart to not only pray and fast, but to fast and pray, that it raises the frequency of their spirit. It raises the frequency of their voice.
Sure.
I believe that we are in a moment, Pastor, where there's so much noise. Everybody's online. Everybody's talking that talk. Prayerfully, they're walking that walk. But yet God sets apart people.
Right.
Not who ride the wave, but they raise the tide.
Whoa.
The people that raise the tide.
You got to write that down. Somebody got to write that down.
I think I wrote it down somewhere. But I'm with you as someone like that because you have committed your life to prayer and to fasting. What do you think about some of that stuff?
Well, see, here's the thing, Al. And like, you're just throwing me pitches, man. I'm just, you're the perfect setup guy, man. So, Celtic style, not the Lakers.
Lakers.
Come on, Tatum. Come on, somebody. No, so just a couple of days ago, my son, who's a powerful prayer warrior, he spent 3 months in Ghana with one of my dear friends, Prophet Gideon Danso, praying 10, 12 hours a day. And he came back on fire. And now, I mean, Al, he is a preaching machine, man. I had him speak for me in one of my morning prayers. And he said this. He said, there are some people that are married to distraction.
Ooh.
Yeah. So somebody write that down. Married to distraction. So what happens is that when you fast, is that it's like, you know, if you fast and you're going to do like an absolute fast with just water, it's like your body is going to have to slow down.
Right.
You're not going to be able to do everything that you could do before.
Right.
When you're fasting, you should turn off the television. You should fast. If right now you listen to secular music because you and your girl want to kind of get romantic during that fast, you don't want to listen to that type of stuff because you don't want any distractions. You don't want anything, hear me, that's going to hinder your antenna to be able to hear what thus saith the Lord.
That's right.
And there are too many people out that they are married to their distractions or they are comfortable in their disaster. They are comfortable in their normal. They are comfortable in their status quo. Now, I know that, you know, you have beautiful daughters, beautiful family. You know, I have a daughter, I have a son, I have three grandchildren. And my children and my spiritual children, they've asked me this question. They said, Dad, you know, or Pastor or Pop, you know, when can we go back? When is life ever going to go back to normal? When are things ever going to go back? Right. And I think one of the hardest answers that I've had to give as a father, as a pastor, as a leader, is biblically, we can't go back.
Ooh, come on. That's right.
That from a biblical standpoint, the Lord speaks to the children of Jeremiah through the prophet of Jeremiah while they're in not quarantine, but they're in exile. They've been carried off into Babylon. He says, build houses and settle down. increase, don't decrease, which means that God is always speaking a word of increase.
That's right.
But in that process of increase, sometimes he has to quiet us. Sometimes he has to still all the voices. There's a song that says, let all the other names fade away.
Right.
Until I love that song. There's only you. And so that we can quiet ourselves. And that's what fasting does. Fasting actually helps you to quiet your spirit so that you can hear God. Like in my time of prayer, Al, and I spend blocks of prayer, blocks of time in prayer, where I spend hours in prayer. And in some of those, say if I take a 3-block hour of prayer, a good portion of that prayer will be worship.
Right.
A good worship of that prayer will be me speaking in a heavenly language.
Right.
But another major portion of that prayer is me, I'm just going to be quiet.
Yes.
I'm going to be still. I want to hear the voice of the Lord. I want to hear what he is saying to me in this season. And that's what fasting does, is that fasting, hopefully, it helps you to take your eyes or your spirit or your flesh off of your flesh, and you become more connected to the spirit so that now God speaks through everything. He speaks through a fly that's flying around in the house. He speaks through, you know what I'm saying? You open the refrigerator and you're feeling hungry and you hear the Lord saying, I want you to hunger and thirst after
there
me.
You go.
It's like fasting.
You get sermons. You get sermons out of it.
Fasting will cause you to divorce your distractions.
Absolutely. And you know what? It's true, because you'll see things, and God will even give you sermons. I get sermons off all these crazy things. Even Sunday, I preached about Kobe's death, and I preached a whole sermon about champions.
Wow.
I know you would have loved that sermon.
I love Kobe Bryant.
Yeah, I know you do. I know you do.
Listen. I'm a boss. I'm from Boston. My brother here is from, well, you're from New York,
LA.
But you live in LA.
From LA.
You're LA. So I'm saying, listen, world, I went to San Diego and my brother here brought me to a Lakers game. And for one day, for one night, I was a Lakers fan.
I tried to convert you.
I felt the groove. You know what I'm saying? I felt the atmosphere in the Staples Center. And it was something special, man.
Come on, bro. Yeah, but like you were saying about fasting, you know, Pastor Matt, in this season right now, you know, I've learned from my pastor that when you pray, you have to learn how to talk to God like a friend.
Yeah.
You know, God, he is in charge. He's got everything under control. And I'm listening more than ever. You know, I made a vow to the Lord. I think I mentioned to you when you came that this year I was going to strive to fast 100 days.
Yeah.
And, you know, I've been fasting many, many days. In fact, I just came off a fast yesterday, and it was glorious. It was great to be able to taste food. But in the time of prayer, and I'm fasting probably 5 days a week right now.
Yeah.
It really has been that time of hearing God. And I just feel like this is a season, Pastor Matt, where – you know, we're not going to pray this virus away. We're going to repent this virus away.
Yeah.
You know, we spent so much time talking to God about what we need. And God, we need to hear God talk to us about what he wants to do in the earth.
Yeah.
And I believe that before he reveals anything to his people, or he does anything, he reveals it first to his prophets, his servants, the prophets. And
yes,
I believe that there are people out there on the war room tonight. This is a season to listen.
Yes.
What do you think? Yes. I mean, well, you talked about it already. You know.
No. This is a season. No, we're in the flow right now. We're there. Like the presence of God is actually. So you're in a space. Hear me. Where this is what you have to say to the Lord. You have to say to the Lord, "Speak, Lord, for your servant is listening."
He's listening, yes.
And then you have to prepare yourself to listen, which means that one of the hardest things that we could ever do is just to still our voices so quiet that we can hear our own heartbeat. And so Samuel, you know the story. Mm-hmm. Hannah praying for a son. The Lord gives her a son. She weans him. She brings him back to the temple. Eli is there. Eli is laying in his normal place. Samuel hears the voice of the Lord. After 3 times, he goes to Eli. Did you call me? Eli said no. Eli thinks to himself, wait a minute. This young boy has not heard the voice of the Lord. You know, I don't even know if Eli had yet heard the voice of the Lord yet. That's a whole other thing to talk about.
But right.
He says, maybe this Samuel hasn't heard the voice of the Lord yet. So he says this, if the Lord calls you again, that's one of the scariest passages of scriptures in the Bible for me. It's possible that the Lord is tired of calling you, that the Ooh. Lord is tired of speaking to you, and he has given you instruction after instruction after instruction. You've gone through calamity after calamity after calamity.
My
You've
God.
Gone through challenge after challenge after challenge. And now, in the middle of this pandemic, if you can't hear God now, like if you can't discern what God is saying to you right now and the body of Christ and to the church and for the kingdom. And so you got to quiet your spirit and you have to say, Lord, speak, Lord, for your servant is listening. Because the greatest thing in all the earth, Al, as you know, is to be able to hear the voice of God. My Yes. life has been completely changed and shifted and altered because of just one word from God. Just one word.
Good Lord. I think this is a good time to pray, Pastor Matt. And I know it's 11 o'clock your time tonight. Wow. You know, someone said this, Pastor Matthew, and I really believe God's going to use you to set some people free right now and break some people through.
Yeah.
There are three types of people. There are those who are part of the army of God, those who are in the enemy's army, and then there's the prisoners of war.
Yeah, wow.
And we're in a season right now where I do believe that the Lord is calling people and he's trying to call them through this situation, but the enemy has them locked in a prison of fear, anxiety, guilt, condemnation,
yeah,
depression. There's even some people that themselves or a family member are in bondage tonight. They say alcohol consumption is up 50-some%.
Wow.
I'm sure drug addiction is up. Wow. You know, people don't know how to deal with what they're feeling.
Yeah.
Don't know how to deal with what's going on in their life, Pastor Matthew. And even certain Christians who in this moment right now who are listening to us, minister and share, and just talk like friends because we're real life friends. This is how we talk together.
Oh, yeah, man. This is awesome.
It's our time.
This is how it flows, man.
It does. But Matthew, minister to the people tonight.
Yeah. Well, there's a song that one of my spiritual sons, who is one of the incredible writers in our church, he wrote a song called There Is No Bondage. Every chain is broken. And so I just want to, for those of you that are watching right now, I want you to know that there is no condemnation.
Yes.
There is no condemnation. Every chain is broken. There is no temptation that is known to man that he has not provided a way of escape. And I want to remind you that God is a God of second chances and third chances and fourth chances. And he's giving you an opportunity, a chance right now to reprioritize your life, to press reset, to begin again. The Bible says, therefore, if any man be in Christ, he's a new creation. The old man is gone and the new man is come. And there are some pastors, there are some leaders, there are some even church mothers that you've grown tired, you've grown weary.
Come on.
But I'm praying that in this prophetic moment, in this prophetic season, that new strength is coming to you. They that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like an eagle. They shall run and not grow weary and walk and not faint. And so just bow your heads with me. Father, I pray right now in the mighty, matchless name of Jesus Christ, that Father, that you would be our Jehovah Shammah, that you would be our very present help in the time of trouble.
Yes.
And not only are you our present help, but you are our pre-sent help, which means that you have already pre-sent yourself. You are already in our future. You are ahead of our future. You are the Alpha and the Omega. You're the beginning and the end. Father, we may be surprised by what is happening now, but this has come to no surprise to you.
Yes, Lord.
And so, Father, we thank you for those, Lord, that are battling with addiction, that are battling with the complexities of being home and quarantined.
Yes, Lord.
And Lord, I pray and I cancel every single demonic attack, every generational curse that will try to hinder these from walking in the prophetic destiny that you have prepared for them. And so, Father, as an army of intercessors, as me and my brother pray together and unite together and agree together, we speak, devil, take your hands off of God's children.
Yes, Lord.
Release them now. Let them go. And Father, we thank you that you're going to use these as the next Joshua, as the next Esther, as the next Moses, as the next Paul, to shift something upon the earth. We give your name the praise, the honor, and the glory for what you've done, what you're doing, and what you're going to do. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen. Wow. Woo! I feel the Lord moving. I just feel his presence so thick right now. And if you're listening, I know you feel him as well. There's no limit with the Holy Spirit. There's no distance in prayer. I also want to take this moment to pray for those of you who are sick in body. Those who are struggling with sickness in your body, we cancel out every fever.
Yeah.
Every fever right now. We cause it to come back to its normal place in the name of Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
Father, I want to lift up those who have other things taking place in their body. They may not be dealing with COVID-19, but we pray for high blood pressure. Father God, we pray for the heart right now. The blood that flows through the veins, oh God, we can feel the movement of your Holy Spirit even now, Father God. And I pray for those with high blood pressure, God, that you will bring their numbers to normal, calm their heartbeat, their spirit, oh God. We pray for those with sugar diabetes, God. We come against any dysfunction in their body, in their pancreas, their kidneys, their liver. Father God, right now we pray you touch all of their organs right now in the mighty name of Jesus, God. We release supernatural healing, Father God, in your name right now. Father, I come against a spirit of depression, Father God, anxiety, fear. We begin to pray, Father God, joy be released, Father God. We pray hope be released right now, Father God. We pray, God, that you would begin to release fresh vision into their life, God. Yes, Father God, for you know the plans you have for them, plans of good and not of evil, plans to give them a future and a hope, Father God. We speak that over their life right now. We speak that over their marriage, Father God. Yes, their marriage is going to get better. Yes, their children are going to get better. Yes, the atmosphere in their home. I sense it shifting right now, Father God. It's shifting right now in their home, Father God. We come against strife. We come against division right now in the mighty, mighty name of Jesus, Father God. We release peace, comfort, rest, Father God, right now into their home, God. We thank you, God, that communication, healthy communication be released, Father God, in their home. We come against curse words and we cancel out all that, those words that destroy life and death are in the power of the tongue. Father, we speak life over their families, life over their marriages, life over their children right now in the mighty name of Jesus, God. Let life begin to swell up in that environment right now. Let joy begin to swell up in that environment right now. We thank you. And Lord, we come against lack, the stress of lack. Lord, you are our provider, Father God. And we speak to the lies of the enemy, that the devourer be cursed in Jesus' name.
Yeah.
Father, as we have kept you first in all areas of our life, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. You said all things shall be added unto us. You said, bring the whole tithe into the storehouse that there might be food. You said, and test me in this, that I would not throw open the floodgates of heaven and curse the devourer, Father God. So we render the devourer cursed in the mighty name of Jesus, God. You said that you would increase your people greatly and they would become stronger than their adversaries, oh God. So we release increase of finances over your people. We release, Father God, tremendous blessings, God, over your people, Father God.
Yeah.
We pray finances that will come from the north, the south, the east, and the west, Father God, into their bank accounts, Father God. Provision, Father God, supernaturally, God. We love you and we thank you. In the mighty name of Jesus, we thank you. Amen. Amen.
Ah, you, my brother.
Brother, man, you got to give me a fist pound on the screen.
Yo, man, I love you, man.
Love you,
I love
too,
you,
bro.
Man. I love you. I love your ministry, man. You already know, man, you are always in my prayers, man.
You too, brother. I pray for you every day. I love you, you and Mona and Maddie and everybody.
All right.
And when we open up these doors, man, you promise you're going to come see me, right?
I'm there, man. I'm there. And you're coming to Boston.
Oh, you know it. You know it.
Love you, bro.
Love you, bro. Be blessed.
Love you, man.
I'll call you soon.
Talk to you soon.
All right. God bless. Woo. Well, guys, you can feel the Lord. I feel the Lord moving in a mighty way. We have a number of people still tuned on. And if you received healing in your body or breakthrough, just like hit the thumbs up or hit the hearts. Many of you are doing that already. What a powerful talk, huh, Tim?
Yeah, I mean, just tremendous. And I really, the Spirit of God was, you could hear the voice of the Lord just speaking right through both of you tonight. And we've had so many great responses, Pastor. I mean, just the spiritual strategy, the blueprint of heaven being revealed. Powerful tonight. Powerful.
We have someone here that put VO Dorchester 2021. Let's do it, man. Let's plant a church in the Boston area.
Yes.
You know, I could feel the anointing so strong right now. And what I love about Pastor Matthew is he really has a way of challenging you in the area of prayer. And the Bible says iron sharpens iron. So does a man sharpen another man's countenance. Yeah. And I could certainly say that God has used him to sharpen me in the area of prayer and fasting.
Yeah.
And I thank God for him. I thank God for his life. I thank God for his ministry. And I really believe that there are many in this hour, in this moment, where God is raising up intercessors in the ministry of Victory Outreach.
Yeah.
There is a tremendous need right now for intercessors to begin to rise up. And we're in a 30-day consecration as a ministry.
Yeah.
And our church has been assigned 8 p.m. every night to pray. And it's actually 8 p.m. right now, 8:06.
Yeah.
And so we're in that moment right now where we're assigned as a region to begin to pray. Pray for our president, our government, pray for our founders, pray against this virus.
Yeah.
And I also pray for our people.
Yeah.
I know you're feeling what I'm feeling.
Yes.
Would you begin to pray for our people?
Yes.
Begin to pray for the churches in our region and keep that music going. I feel the anointing.
Yeah, Pastor, there's people getting healed.
Go ahead.
Someone's blood pressure has been brought to normal. Jerry, who's watching us.
Thank
someone's
you, Lord.
Feeling the power of God right in their living room right now. And so even yesterday, someone was healed instantly as we were praying for somebody, and she's still feeling the power of God. So there's the power of God's moving, Pastor.
Go ahead and pray for the people. Go ahead and pray for our churches.
Yes, Father, we thank you right now, Lord, and we thank you for the anointing of the Holy Spirit. God, that is so, that's so powerful, God, even through tonight, through Pastor Matthew and Pastor Al, God, just the spiritual strategy that's been revealed, oh God, the blueprint of heaven that's been revealed. Father, we thank you even right now, God, for the power and the movement of your Holy Spirit through these airways. Father, we bind the prince of the air in the mighty name of Jesus. And as we declare territory, Father, it was prophesied tonight that we are going to take these airways. And Father, we plead the blood of Jesus, God, over these airwaves, God, over the churches, Lord, that is proclaiming and speaking your word today, Father. For we make a declaration, Father, and we speak even now to those that are receiving this word through the airwaves, that Father, every church that is within our region, our multi-region, within our ministry, Father, that is listening, tuned in tonight, Father, in this global hour of prayer, that Lord, that we would plead the blood of Jesus, God, over our founders, over our leadership, over our churches. And even now, God, for those that are receiving your healing, that, Father, you would complete that. Even now, Father, that you would release the power and the anointing of the Holy Spirit. I thank you, Father, and I sense your warmth and your love, Father, upon your people, upon your children. For, Father, it is your good pleasure to give us the kingdom, Father.
Yes.
And we receive that, and we thank you for that, and we declare it in Jesus' mighty name, Father God.
Thank you, Lord God. Thank you, Jesus.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Well, what a powerful night. What a powerful night. And it's dark out here, but it's peaceful out here.
Come on, I feel the anointing's all over this place, Pastor. It's heavy. It's thick.
Go filled. I feel the glory cloud of the Lord. You know, in this hour, God is raising up prayer warriors.
Yeah.
He's raising up prayer warriors. He's raising up not just preachers, but prayer warriors. And I want to be a part of that. You know, we pray those of you that are listening also have a desire to be people of prayer.
Yeah.
Tomorrow morning, I'm going to be ministering to the desert, to the high desert region on their Facebook page for morning devotion at 7 a.m. I encourage people to tune in to that tomorrow morning.
Yeah.
So if you haven't had an opportunity to watch our service from yesterday,
you gotta do it.
I talked about Shammah. Mm-hmm. Shammah.
Yeah.
David's mighty men, and he positioned himself in the field, and he pushed the enemy out of the field. He killed the Philistines, and his name is derived from Jehovah Shammah. The Lord is there.
Yeah.
Amen. And so we're talking about spiritual warfare. You want to watch that service. And then on Wednesday before that, I preached on spiritual authority. And it's another message I believe people want to tune into. I'm feeling stirred to speak on warfare right now, Tim. That's what I'm feeling. What are you feeling God doing right now?
No, I think, as I mentioned to you on Sunday, I feel that you are the message that was spoken, and you got to listen to it because it's so prophetic. It is so timely for the body of Christ and even for us as Victory Outreach, because we've heard our founders declare that we are an end times ministry. And really, when you talk about the frequencies of heaven, Pastor, when you were talking about an open heaven increases frequencies and just really the weapons that we've been weaponized with, that word was truly, I mean, it was on time, because there was such an awareness to how the enemy tries to plot and watch and try to take us out.
Yeah.
But warfare allows us to be sharp in the spirit, be ready for the attack, and just really understanding the frequencies and listening to one voice, one sound.
Absolutely.
As we are hearing the Lion of Judah roar throughout the land. So I really believe that it was such a timely message, just really shaping us to where we need to go in this next season. Because now we've heard this, we've heard you even say this to us, this shall come to pass. And now we're getting ready to enter in to this next season. And I believe warfare is going to be very strategic as we take on as an army moving forward. So it was powerful.
You know, new seasons create new opportunities. And when we came into this year, you know, I told the church, I'm not going to preach on the vision because we know the vision.
Right.
But this is a year where God is going to open us up to new opportunities. Little could we imagine how great of opportunities the Lord has given us.
Wow.
And, in new seasons, God gives new opportunities, but in new season, God also raises up new champions.
Yes.
And this is a moment and a season where revival is not only to restore, to renew, and to recover what the enemy has stolen, but it's a time of revelation.
Yes.
It's a time where new heroes begin to rise.
Yes.
See, when the kingdom was shifted from Saul to David, with David came 37 mighty men of valor.
Right.
And just as Pastor Sonny has been praying for revival and Victory Outreach.
Right.
And praying for this third wave to rise up.
Yeah.
This is a moment where God is going to raise up new champions in this season, who are going to pray, who are going to fast, who are going to hear the voice of God, who are going to say what they hear. Yeah. Amen.
Amen.
And say what they see, say what they hear, and say what they feel. So it's going to be very, very powerful.
Yeah.
Man, I don't even know. Man, I'm just enjoying being out here tonight.
I know that tonight was so powerful. I mean, it was just so anointed tonight, Pastor. I mean, the response.
Let's read some comments.
Yeah, I mean, let's go back here. I'd have to circle back. But even tonight, people were just commenting how powerful it was. And
yeah, a lot of people tuned in tonight. I'm looking at these comments. Victory to Montebello. Mm-hmm. Montebello, I used to live on Beverly Boulevard. What's up? He's blowing my mind. He revived my heart. So I went to anoint and pray over my mom today. And she said she felt heat come from my hand even before I began to pray. God is doing it.
Wow.
Hallelujah. Let me see this other one. Fasting is the key for breakthrough. Amen. Yeah. And amen. Yeah. Someone said, I feel God's presence.
Yep.
Let me see. Power packed hour. I can feel the Lord so powerful. All right. I take daily reading of my blood pressure, which has been better than normal during time of prayer. Congratulations. Yes.
Yep.
Beautiful. Let's
power of God's moving.
Oh my God. Definitely, definitely. Amen. Break alcoholism, anxiety, and depression right now. That's what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
Praise the Lord. Pray for people in third world countries dealing with this pandemic. Absolutely.
Yeah.
The power of the Lord is touching. What else do we have here? So many comments.
It's just so powerful. I mean, even when Pastor Matthew was talking about how this is our time as a body to take over the airwaves, even our time in our ministry, Pastor, you could really sense just even now the tangible results. I mean, you said this earlier in the beginning of the show, the Holy Spirit's not limited to how he can move. And so you feel it tonight. Powerful, powerful war room tonight. I'm excited for next Monday. I don't know what's going to happen.
I didn't mention Matthew's new album, Jubilee's new album, The Worship.
Oh, yeah.
They can go on and they can stream that, Jubilee.
Yes.
On any platform. iTunes. Yeah, iTunes or any platform, YouTube.
Freedom is our song.
Freedom is our song. That's the one. They need to go and stream. That's powerful. And I'm praying that our church will one day be able to create a sound.
Come on now. There it is.
Worship is a sound. It's not a song. It's a sound.
A sound. Yes. One sound. I love how we share that. One sound.
One sound. Praise God. All right, Tim. Well, we better go.
We're going to jump into some prayer with our region. So, Pastor, it was awesome. I'm excited. Friday night, you're going to be dropping it on the podcast, Kingdom Shifters. So
What time?
We're going to do it this Friday night, 8 o'clock. So it'll be exciting. We're going to pray. We're going to knock hearts. And then we're going to just, I can't wait. You're going to let it rip. So it's going to be great.
Amen. Praise God. All right, guys, we love you. Thanks for tuning in the War Room.
Yes.